Well, it's fine.
Nope, but what was I gonna say? Because a collab like that doesn't sound like a modern game thing. It sounds like something they'd do because, like, oh yeah, the original did it, we should do that. Like, there's no way the original didn't have Spyro in it. It just, you know.
My cock is much bigger than yours.
Oh my god, my car is... Okay. Oh my god, guys, I just golded. How crazy is that?
It's a clean start!
Damn it. Okay, no boost. Chop Suey, Chop Suey's on, Chop Suey's fucking on, let's fucking go. Oh my god, Chop Suey is the most perfect thing to be created in this world. I don't know if I'd say it's like my favorite song ever, because picking a favorite song, that sounds weird, but I'd be willing to call it like the greatest song ever. And just know that there's a difference when I say that, between favorite and greatest. Dude, I gotta turn this shit up. Where's my phone? Okay. Turn that shit up, bro.
You ready to see some real action?
Grab a brush and put on a little makeup. I discourse the fade away, the shake up. Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? Here you go, create another fable. You wanted to. Grab a brush and put on a little makeup. You wanted to. I discourse the fade away, the shake up. You wanted to. Why'd you leave the keys up on the table? You wanted to. Well, I don't think you trust. In my self-righteous suicide, I cry when angels deserve to die. Fun fact, that line actually reminds me of something. If you upload any video onto YouTube and it has the scene from God of War 1 where Kratos tries committing suicide at the start, it actually gets like age restricted by YouTube. It's like, damn, bro. I've seen some worse shit that's like just lying around there fine. I've even seen some shit that says it's for kids when it's clearly not. But a video game character. Whew, that's a little too much, you know? There's literally naked fucking tits in God of War, and you brutally murder people, and yet Kratos committing suicide is what, like, gets it age restricted. This song went from...
Wow.
Fuck. Got crushed directly. I really should have reset my console. If you leave the game running for too long, the game can crash. So I'm taking a massive risk right now. Self-righteous suicide, I cry. deserve to die in my self-righteous suicide. I cry when angels deserve to die.
Yeah, the story doesn't, but that's no, that's.
Three, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, hell yeah. Alright. This is the one track I know, so I'm obviously gonna do really well on this track, right? That was a good crane drift, actually. Damn it, I still hit the boost pad. And now I missed that boost, so we're taking a bit of a boost detour. Still not enough. Dude, I want genocidal humanoids to come up, damn it. Spotify, you know what I want, give me. Give me. Give me genocidal humanoids. My other favorite is still a down song. A 133? Damn! I got a 133 on that, even with all the mistakes.
It's a clean start.
Even just the small amount of grinding I've done on Seaport like has helped me. PB Mania on Seaport Strip. Yeah, it's not a PB actually. My PB is a 133.06, but I don't know what the exact milliseconds on that were, but it was, I think it was like a decently close. Also, we're now on the tour track, which is fun. I probably should have gone for the left one, but was playing this like C port. Okay, that was a bit too wide of a drift. Or that was a bit too wide of a turn, so I had to, so I resorted to drifting. Watch either CTR or CTR Nitro Field. Okay, wait, I'll read. I'm getting close to the end of this track. I'll definitely be able to read that.
All right, time for the shit tracks. And drifting, you can't really change from drifting big open spaces.
I might actually like start from Haven City tracks, just because they're genuinely like the worst. Are you serious, man? Bruh.
fact that I'm losing time, especially this amount, is like, it should show you how bad this track is. How bad all of these are. Has more modes than well, considering that's based off a PS1 game that already would have had less modes. But also, I won't be surprised if like they took some out of the original. Not that I know much, because you know. But like, I genuinely would not be like opposed to believing they actually took some shit out of the original, because that's just how a lot of remakes tend to be nowadays. They just cut content. Why is that flag there if it's not actually gonna be a fucking finish line? Not like how you hit the flag, but gotta keep going. Make any sort of sewer levels. Jack 2.
Okay, well, at least I'm 45 seconds ahead now.
Ready, go!
I think the strat from now on is gonna be to start with the Haven City tracks so that the early game will be the like the hardest and worst part. It also means I can end off with my favorite tracks. Someone went live. I wonder who could that be. Surely not Marathon Man. Actually, I don't know if it's Marathon Man because I'll get a Discord ping. I'm like on the verge of my car exploding. Never mind. Fuck the system, this is a good one. Fuck the system is like a good system of a down song.
Okay. I believe made a good opening in Mega Mix. Yikes take. I know it probably doesn't apply to CTR, what I said earlier about remakes like not being the same. It's mostly a,
I'm just a boomer in that way. Also because the Ratchet and Clank remake, reboot, reimagining combo, it literally is exactly that. I know like the Resident Evil 3 remake took out a lot of content, and what are some other remakes that I know of? Oh my fucking god, that was yikes. I'm sure it's actually good, maybe, I don't know. I actually have no opinion on it other than it's like, I definitely tend to be like very old school with games, with PlayStation games especially, because like remakes of like stuff is something that like doesn't interest me. Reboot was basically made for kids. The reboot was made for fucking 2 IQ people. The reboot was made for journalists. Journalists that don't even know the difference between a remaster and a remake. Like, there are journalists that called Rack PS4 a fucking remaster. It's like, don't you dare diss the OG game like that ever again, IGN. I don't know if IGN ever called it that, but it sounds like something they do. Something that Ricky does that I also do is that we're both just very not, which one is this song again? Oh, this is AEI, the one that's like a bunch of letters I fucking forget. Is that, like me, he's definitely not a fan of remakes. I don't think he's ever, I don't know what remakes of games he loves that he's played. I don't know any of that. And I don't know, I don't think he'd want remakes of like games like Jack, for example. I think he would genuinely be against it, kind of like me. I've just never really been a fan of that thing. Like, there's some remakes that I may be down to play, but like, for the most part, not really. One of the only remakes I even kind of care about is the Resident Evil 4 remake, because that actually looks like it'll have something of fun to it. Also, Eastern Tour time, baby. This is the worst track because it's literally all the bad tracks in one. Why did the car not turn? Okay, I really, really could use some help. Where is that? Damn it! Right fucking there and I missed it. One time Emerald said Roulette was his, one of his least favorite System of a Down songs, and I was about to fucking dox that motherfucker. Okay, no I wasn't actually. For legal reasons, that's a joke. No, but like, bro, Emerald. Yeah, I'm glad that he listens to System of a Down. Oh my god. I tried looking at chat. Diva Jack remake be like microtransaction, it'd be worse. Like, I can think of so many ways that they'd ruin Jack if they ever remade these games. They remade Jack. They like cut half the content, make the cutscenes like not funny. they would not give Ashlyn the big booba that we all love. I mean, what? Wouldn't be as edgy. For sure. I like Ashlyn for the plot, yeah. Ashlyn's my favorite character. She has such a huge and intriguing backstory. Are you fucking serious, dude? Almost done with the shit track. Oh my god, I'm so glad I didn't crash my car. Okay, we're right here. It's like right here. Like one more turn. There we go. Nightmare is over.
Okay. I hated the protect mission, the one where you have to get young. I remember that being like the only like protect mission that wasn't total dog shit.
But I can say that like the one in the sewers where you have to protect the three guys was actual fucking AIDS, especially with the lack of checkpoints. Once I'm Emerald was playing Jack 2, and he was playing Jack 2 and he was on that mission, and apparently, like, I forget what caused it, but I think it's like if you get too far away from the three guys that you protect, I think it's like if they go too far without you, then the mission fails. And so he was just waiting around there for a little bit, like, with the game on pause. I don't even remember why, and then the mission failed, and he was like, what? And he had to start from the beginning. Fun fact about hard missions and platformers, Pachinko Machine in Super Mario Sunshine, I'm sure that gives, like, trauma to a lot of people. The first time I ever played it myself, this was like, when was this? This was like the summer maybe. I literally beat it within like 10 minutes. Not first try, but in like 10 minutes. It's like, huh, that wasn't so bad. No, but I understand why people like fucking hate it, but like, I was just impressed that with my superb skills, and by that I mean none, because I don't play Mario games that much. Like I was a casual. Just watching me do the boosts here makes you appreciate the wanton CTR. I don't know how different Nitro Fueled is to the original, but I wonder what it's going to be like to play that one. From the tiny bit of footage I've seen, it looks, it looks a lot more smoother to play. Like, this one was clearly trying to go for something a little bit more intense with the physics.
Give you an boost doesn't even. What do you mean? Give you an indication for when you should boost?
Oh, do you mean the starting boost? If you mean the starting boost, then yeah, that's actually like pure cruelty. Because it's not when it goes to green; it's a tiny bit before that.
Kombucha, mushroom, people sitting around all day. Who can believe you? Who can believe you? That
sugar. Dude, that was so timed when he said sugar and the car just fucking flew into fucking air. Also, I missed the help. Who can believe you? Who can believe you? That your mother. The fact that I had to like come up with a timing method of each like beat in the countdown, splitting up it into 6 bits, and then having to time it on like either the 4th or 5th count. I'm not even sure, like 100%. Like. That's just insane. And the fact that I don't even always get it. Ooh, baby! Maybe that person might resurface. Maybe.
Maybe not. I felt like the biggest asshole. Biggest.
Is this the truck with the really weird turn? biggest asshole. How many times does he repeat? System mode down is genius. So the little thing about this song, Aerials, by System of a Down, is that the little riff at the start sounds identical to a song by 3 Days Grace called Take Me Under.
Oh, and the cow goes wild!
Oh my god, dude, why would you spawn me like that? Why would you spawn me there, facing that direction? I mildly regret running it back, because it's like, this run's still going to be like an hour long probably, and it is like, going to be 3 in the morning, but yeah.
About this one to give you exclusives, so when you beat something hard, like, yeah, that's cool, like, having extra content is like, just the way to go.
It's a clean start.
Okay, we're also doing the tour now. Like, one thing that, or initially, like, Resident Evil 4 was one is a game that, like, I remember, like, for a lot of reasons, but one thing it did was that as soon as, like, I beat it, I was obsessed with it, because it was just, like, unlike anything I'd seen, even though it was only, like, a little over a year ago, because I haven't played too many games, like, ever, so Resi 4, like, set a really high bar, like, it was just amazing, but one of the things that really, really, really hooked me onto it was all the extra content when you beat the game. It's like, dude, the remake will not have as much content as the original, I can tell you that. In fact, I don't think any game in the world features that much content when you beat it. Or maybe there's some game. It had an extra campaign. It had NG Plus for the main campaign and the extra campaign. Had two different types of minigames, one of them just being like a quick little 1 hour like thing. I don't even fucking know how to describe it. And then the other was like a kill enemies to get points type of game. Then you had extra costumes, extra weapons, and like cutscene viewers and shit, and it's just like, holy fuck, dude. You know damn well this would have been a DLC in like a modern game. All this would have been DLC, and the extra campaigns would like be complete shit, and the base game would already like be shit if this was a modern game. But no, 2005 they were setting high bars. No.
This is amazing, folks!
Hola, hola, Johan. ¿Cómo estás? Es que siento como que tuve algo que decirte, pero ahora ya se me olvidó. Se fue la madre. No voy a estar leyendo el chat mucho mientras que estoy jugando las carreras, pero cuando estoy seleccionando una carrera, un evento, yo puedo leer. Así que yo no sé si yo leí tu mensaje tarde, pero no vas a acordarte de eso. Ay, pinche madre. A ver, yo tengo mucho que leer. I have a lot of chat to read.
Okay. It's nearly 12, so it's nap time. Hope I get it. Alright, see you later, Tui. Pasando el rato, no tengo sueño. Si hablaste no te escuché, nomás estoy diciendo que no voy a leer mucho el chat mientras estoy en las carreras. Porque pues este es un juego difícil, más o menos, para jugar bien sin que andes chocando tanto. No entendí lo que dijo el otro de sí, no entendí nada. Oh, tuya. Él usó unas palabras que serán difíciles de traducir. Más o menos.
Pero nomás digo que él iba a la cama.
Casi termino. ¿Este juego es sobre carreras o hay plataformas? No, este es un juego de carreras. Puro carreras.
Los primeros tres de Jak and Daxter tienen como plataformas, pero este es pura carrera. Es el punto del juego. Hasta el juego, ese es el nombre del juego, como en español será Jakax con carreras de combate. Yo estoy haciendo los contrarreloj. Pero en eventos normales, como carreras reales. Siempre tienes otras personas lanzando armas a tu carro. Auto. Yo voy a llamarlo auto porque no puedo rasear mis áreas. Y tu auto también puede disparar armas. Y eso que no usas Ratchet. Yo lo usé en el otro speedrun que acabo de completar. Este es el segundo speedrun que voy a completar. Pero yo pensaba, ¿sabes qué? Yo voy a usar el modelo de Jak de Jak 1. Nomás para cambiar cosas, ¿entiendes? La próxima vez yo voy a volver a Ratchet, yo creo. O voy a usar el modelo de Jak de los otros juegos. Quedan 4 carreras. Such a The most loneliest day of my life. Eso es francés o alemán. Este es portugués. El juego está en portugués porque pensaste que el juego tiene una opción de portugués. Si me ayuda a acordar más, palabras que involucrados con videojuegos, para poder hablar con los brasileños. Así que yo lo tengo en portugués para ojalá entender un poco más palabras, especialmente involucrados con videojuegos, para que cuando hablo con los brasileños, cuando estoy jugando God of War, o cuando ya empiezo jugar Resident Evil 4, cuando los brasileños están en el chat, puedo hablar con ellos bien. La neta, yo estoy sorprendido que solo escogiste a francés o alemán como las dos opciones que pensaste que eran esos, porque portugués se parece casi igual a español. I also want to give this a- Oh my god, a Scarlet reviewer? Hello? Hello? Pick- Okay, wait, I want to read your name properly. Pika Mayraline. Okay, that's a nice name, actually. Eso que estoy viendo, y esos tampoco ayudan de- Oh, entendido. Soy un pendejo. Se me olvida que tu internet no es muy bueno. Ah, lo siento, hermano. Anyways, hi Pika. I see you are a Scarlet reviewer based on that nice little emote he has. I literally wanted to do this just because he was doing it on stream. And yeah, you should give this a go. Finally gave me reasons to drive this car. Yeah. When I played this game casually, when I did my casual playthrough, I upgraded nothing until I got to this car just so I knew I'd have the orbs. I also upgraded another car, but that was just so I could complete the game casually. Because this car isn't the best for certain tracks. Everybody sucks. Everybody sucks. Everybody dies. I missed the boost, fuck. I'm gonna try and get a little closer to my computer so it's easier to read certain messages. By that I mean all the messages. You lent pornography, chips and sodomy. Shit, you on the TV. I forget some of these lyrics. Dude, my thumb's gonna like fucking hurt like hell from holding X. That's my first non-gold in like a while.
Wait for it. Go!
Also, I'm really close to finishing this run. The question is, can we sub hour? I believe. Unless I like mess up really badly. No, I have the horse. Oh, si estás... A ver, yo no leí todo eso, pero yo leí la palabra bugs. Yo estoy... Hay dos categorías, para esto. A ver, esta categoría se llama, 24 carreras. Ay, puta madre. 24 carreras. Y hay dos opciones. Si quieres una usando bugs, y pulando, partes de las carreteras. Y hay una sin eso, donde nada de eso está permitido. Yo estoy jugando sin eso porque es una los bugs de este juego se parecen como una mamada para tratar de aprender. Como hijo de su pinche madre, qué putazos. Este juego es demasiado difícil. La persona que tiene todos los records mundiales, Scarletra, you know, yo lo pronuncié raro. Viendo a él tratando de hacer todos los skips, fue una... Uf. Se parecen locos. Así que hay ops. Y también como que este es un juego de carreras, es que va a estar gente que van a querer jugarlo sin eso. Así que yo estoy jugándolo sin esto. Okay, I need to like get really good at the very last. Oh wait, this is the last track.
We've got a green light.
Great start. I'm also Canadian, but I speak French.
Crack my smack my bitch right here in Hollywood.
American prison system, every day. In the U.S. I miss every day. Buenas noches, Hawaii. I mean, buenas noches, Johan. You speak some French. Nice. I know that they're, I know that, like, half of Canada is only English. I assume that's where Scarletra's from. And then the other half, like, speaks, like, French. I don't know if, like, it's pure French. I don't know if that half of that part of Canada is, like, only French. Or maybe there's, like, a part of Canada that speaks both. But I always found that so fascinating. Because, like, living in the U.S. and Mexico, like, the U.S. and Mexico are, like, one country, one language, I mean. U.S. is purely, like, English. Like, you do see stuff in other languages, but, like, pretty much everything's in English. And then in Mexico, like, everything's in Spanish, but you do sometimes get stuff written in English. Especially in areas closer to the border. Hell, you can even use American money in, like, some parts. And it's a valid currency. But like Canada's like, you know. Decrease the minimum mandatory minimum sentences. All research and successful drug policy shows that treatment should be increased. And will force them decreased while abolishing mandatory minimum sentences. Also sub hour is unfortunately not happening probably. I don't think sub hour will happen. But we'll see. Only one city is fully bilingual, and it's in New Brunswick, from what I... That's interesting. It's kind of... That feels so cursed that one half of a country speaks only one language, and the other half of the exact same country speaks only one language, but it's not the same one. And that only one city can do both. I'm sure... I think some countries in Europe do that as well, but like... Canada's not Europe. Canada is the Europe of North America. caught a pie. Damn it. This, alright, the sub hour, if this can sub hour, it's really close. Okay, I literally have 10 seconds to finish this track before sub hour is dead. I don't think it's happening, by the way. Yeah, no, it's dead. Okay, so I did not beat all 24 tracks in under an hour, but that's fine. It's still a PB. It's a free PB, boys.
Okay, but we were damn close. Okay, what do you guys wanna worry? Wait, hold on. We have a lot of options for raid targets. A lot.
Neck hurts.
Alright, we have a lot of options for raids. We have four, we have actually more than four options, but like the main ones. Okay. So, I don't know if there's anyone in chat still like awake, but here's the options. Wotan is playing Jack 3, although I don't know what he's doing right now. Sid Sanhu is playing Infamous 2. Marathon Man is playing Ratchet 1. He actually just went live a few minutes ago. And Clovis Senpai is playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist of the Roses. I might raid Clovis since... I might raid Clovis. If like no one answers, but you do have a lot of options. I could also raid Wotan because it'd be funny because Mike GamePro and Scarletra all raided him. Check chat. All right. Pika is thinking real hard. Also, I disconnected my capture card because I'm hauling my ass to bed now. Probably. Ugh. If you want to suggest a target, you know, go ahead. Those are the options that I'm going to go with. I need to let my computer cool down. I don't know who I want to raid. There's so many good options. Ugh. Marathon Man's like my go-to raid, but like Sir Sanjo, I've never really gotten the chance to raid him. Wotan is playing Jack though. Although for some reason I don't follow him, even though I know damn well I've talked in his chat. And Clovis is he's raided me like once, and I feel like I should return the favor. Okay, wait.
Wait, hold on. Does it like... Does it select... Okay, okay. Wait, so... Okay, I can do that, okay. I'm gonna do a random number generator. One is Nick, two is Sanju, three is Wotan, and four is Clovis, so... What did it roll? Two, we're rating Sir Sanju.